Did you know that there is an archive that stores all your notification and activities on the school try portal? Both on the administrative dashboard, parents dashboard, students dashboard, any dashboard, there is an archive that monitors all of these notifications. So how do you have access to this information and how can it be of help to you? This video is for you. Come to your dashboard here, you locate yourself to manage content, and then you click on manage notifications. When you click on manage notifications, you'll be met with a screen that looks like this one. And when you meet with this screen, you will discover that all notifications here are being added at various occasions, yet they come here as a full list of all notifications. Take for example, there are tons of notifications that has been created or that has been sent. Specifically, there are tons of notifications that has been sent to schools, to students, to parents, and this goes in tons of ways. So how can this be of help? Managing notification is what helps you keep track of events, occurrences, activities that is going on your school's portal. With you being able to manage notifications, you get to know which notification goes to whose angle or to whose wing. Parents, teachers' profile, can it be adding a meeting? Can it be adding an event? Can it be paying school fees? Can it be adding an assignment? Can it be adding a document? Or even anything as the case may be. So managing notifications here gives you access to all of the notifications here. As you can see in the numbers tab, this is 5,244th notification here, which means every notification from the day this portal has been activated are going to be stored here permanently. Should in case a need arises to keep track of this information, this is where you have access to them. And then you have the add notification button. Adding a notification is always a thing that the reason is to be clearly identified. Take for example, a notification is often the feedback that comes from an action. We repeat. A notification is often a feedback that comes as a result of an action being initiated. If an assignment is being added, a notification will be sent to the recipients or to the classes that this assignment belongs to. So when you manually create a notification, for which purpose? Manually creating the notification, what exactly has it done? What is the purpose that the notification is serving? Why this notification needs to be added manually? So it's recommended that you depend on notifications that follow an action to avoid misplacement of data or misplacement of information. You might not understand that this notification was manually added when it was added. So technically, every notification is supposed to follow an activity or a task or an action on the portal. So highly it's recommended that no notification should be added manually. But in case of reasons that notifications would be added manually, this is the box that you would come to add the notification manually for any reason that has it. You can click on the main title. You can impute the main title, then the subtitle, the description, and the user. So technically, you could just attach all of this information. But the question again is, what activity initiated the notification? If there is none, then it's recommended that adding the notification should be left alone, and then only focus on the recordings of the existing and the previous notifications over the time. So this is how we'll be wrapping it up on this video on School Try on how to manage notifications. If you enjoyed this video, click on the subscribe button, the like button, the comment button, of course, input your comments. And then visit www.schooltry.com, click on get started to get started.